His Grace, the Archbishop Zakaya Sokwa, the Bishop of Malindi, Emmanuel, Barbara, members of the clergy, honorable members of parliament, the chair of the transitional authority, distinguished guests, good morning.
Good morning.
I'm Jambo. Sometimes, as a Catholic, when His Grace has spoken, you find it difficult to come in. Challenge. But I'll try my best. Challenge. Ladies and gentlemen, members of the clergy, I'm honored and humbled to be here today. I know today is a great day for us as we look at the findings of citizen participation. But I just want to start, and I have told the director, sometimes I like talking off the cuff. Because in devolution, as you have His Grace, even if you have a speech, sometimes it doesn't work. You need to communicate, to talk. But sometimes we look at our country, and I always say, Kenya is a country of miracles. We survive through our miracles. So we need to thank our God. Because one thing is that we have a very good constitution, a constitution that promotes both national and county governments, a constitution that upholds that we need to promote participation, complete participation. But since we don't like laws, all of us, we hate laws in this country. We have so many, but we hate them. So we find it so difficult to move. But if we follow the law and the constitution, as it says, today will be very fun. Today, we will not be talking about admiring Rwanda. Because it is our Kenyans who went there and developed Rwanda. And you go there and you say, oh, Rwanda is so clean. So what happened to you, and it's a Kenyan who has made Rwanda clean? And that is what devolution means. As much as we want to embrace devolution, as much as we understand the diverse of our country, then we need to ask ourselves, who are our leaders? As a Catholic, I know I went through the social teaching. But I'll tell us, and I'll tell you, we've lost it also, as the church. As His Grace tells us, nobody understands revolution. I think I understood the multi-party system through the church. Because every Sunday, they would remind us. They would tell us. It is for us, as Kenyans, to fight for our rights, to fight for change. It was through the church. Now we have devolution. We've decided it's a game of the politicians, who we are. And therefore, we'll politicize so that 2017, I have a game to use to play around and say, you know, these other ones didn't do this, so let me join. So let me go and change. But you have never asked yourself. They have been there for 30 years. Some have been there when we were still young, when we were being brought up, and we have found them. But have we seen the change? No. So we woke up on 4th. And we were taken away again with the same, even as you say, Your Grace, that 2017 they'll vote. They would vote differently. It has not dawned to them that they need change. They'll vote the same people. You make sure. I remember in the civil society, we woke up and told Kenyans, bring in a new crop. Bring in a new crop. Do not mix them, because the few Warus you mix, all of them get gone. But you refuse to brought, you mix them again, and so the new ones and the old ones will teach them the same lesson, and they become the same. And then they come up. And then we are waiting for change. How? So this is one thing we need to talk. The government has taken its initiative. It has given 210 billion, yes. No Kenyan, because of the politics, has asked. The constitution says 15. So when I look at the whole budget, the 1.3 trillion being talked about, what is 210 billion? It is 32%. But the politicians have decided 7% we should take it also to a referendum. Why? And then nobody's looking back to the law and saying, but Article 2 or 3, you can decide and just change it in Parliament and change this article to give Kenyans the 40% without using a penny for the public funds and without making polarizing the country, which right now in the findings is crying for reconciliation. And why are we crying for reconciliation? It's because we know that without peace, whether you give them 10 billion each per county, they will not develop. But I thank God the Senate is there, and you need to support the Senate fully, because all we do is to ensure whatever you get, and you're not getting it in Lamsam. If the governors are thinking that way, then they're, and the chairman of transitional authorities here will testify to that. We have agreed that you get what you spend per month. Because if we don't do that, Kenya will be in the worst than we were 50 years. And the governors should start now even showing to Kenyans, what have I done? As I asked for 7 billion, like my governor of Kakamega, Oparanya, he has 7.3 billion to spend in 1 year. But already you can see the little that they were given, already some of them were not able to even utilize, and some have already mismanaged, 23 counties already. So we have to ask ourselves as Kenyans, do we want to support the process? Do we want to assist in checking? And I know when they were doing the budgets, all of them, none can stand and say they had public participation, none. All they did was to do a budget and then go to the county assembly and decide. The budget process is also a very, very long process. Like now, the budget of 2014-2015 has to start now. In fact, it was supposed to start in August, where now you go back to the counties and then you sit, look at the priorities, and that is where public participation takes place. For now, because again we have been taken into the politics, we've forgotten. Then we will come, 2014, we will rush the same way we've done. But I want to challenge today ourselves, as the church. His Grace has talked about school fees and all that. And I want to thank God, coming from a Catholic background, I started helping many students before I became a missionary. So helping does not mean you have to be emotional. Helping your neighbor means your heart. It means what you think. Even when I have a very small or a salary that I can see, I'm streaming. But if I want to help my neighbor, I will. It's the same way you go and tithe. You won't tell me you don't tithe because you have a small salary or big. No, you tithe. So for us, why we have a challenge with our politicians is because you have decided they'll pay for you school fees, then they'll pay for you your health bill, then they'll pay. But you think they will be greed and they will steal to make all these things work. But if we start as Kenyans from the county to insist we want systems to work, that when I walk into a public hospital, I am able to walk in, get treatment as any other person, and I don't need to be told that now you have to buy this, you have to move from one referral hospital to another to get a CT scan, to get a renal unit. No. That I'm able to get every, and that is what we need to start telling our governors. Now that you have this fund, can you make just one commitment, either on health or food security, that this can work in this county? But do not tell the governor, and the way I can see them asking for wholesome functions, they want to make roads, they want to make health, they want, and yet you have not even asked Mwananchi, what is the priority of this county? What are our priorities? What do we want to do in 1 year when we achieve? That is what we will see ourselves move. But if we support them, say all the functions should come, Then after that, then they start saying, now we've gotten the function. Another 6 months, they'll be saying, now give us the money. We will lose it. And let me tell you, Kenyans, we forget so fast. So in 3 years, we'll be saying, we are better off with the national government. And it's the Mwananchi who will come crying and say, all this thing cannot work. Hatujaona maendeleo, hatujafanya nini, kwa hivyo tunataka turudishiwe serikali yetu ile tumezoea, ile serikali moja ile. But when we were fighting, we were saying there's too much power at the center, now we need to devolve. Therefore, what am I saying? We have to embrace devolution, all of us. Without, it's a new, they call it, everyone is saying it's a new word. It's not a new word because CDF has been there. See, tulishika the concept of CDF. Yes, it's a devolved fund. The same way. So if we embrace it that way and say, if CDF worked, if we saw change, I believe even if the governors work, and each governor individually, not the way they are doing it, we will see change. And I know in a few counties to come, we will see that change. But it is how also we start going back, and the church to assist that every Sunday, you are able now to start talking. And even know the figures that this county has received this much, it is time you start looking at where development is happening, and let even the citizens of that county benefit in terms of seeing a transparent process in even their tendering process and all that. Because again, accountability is resources, but it's also the human resource. And that's another challenge we are going to face. 50 years, we have a huge wage bill. But I'm telling you, if we are not careful, in 1 year, the counties will have the huge wage bill we have never seen. Because they have two employment services board, and each are competing also. And they have staff that was also seconded from government, which the governors have refused, yet they are the expertise in government to assist them to move. So those are some of the challenges. But we need to ask ourselves, what am I doing to ensure it works? Because it is not something we will start blaming government, governor, no. It is all of us. Do we want to see change? Do we want to be Rwanda? Do you want to be Namibia? Where you can walk in and do, just sign one document and have started business. Clean, without using our own panyabits that we do in Kenya. In this country, one of the things that has failed us, and we need to talk about it, is a middle management team that has been in the procurement system for a very long time. And any person who is very comfortable where he is will hate change. And that is one thing that I always say, if we are able to dismantle and bring in new people, then the procurement system will work in this country and we'll see change. But it is the same team, even in the public service, that will sit down and decide, these are the projects, these are the what, and you do deals, and you decide this. Because that's what we do. You are better off, as a Kenyan, having 50 million come on your side. And then whether the project works, it does not work, but you have had your kill. Two, you move on. And that's where we are. We have refused. Even the youth we are talking about today, everyone is looking, how can I be rich? Nobody's working for the country. It is how me can I drive a very big Range Rover. And therefore, we have left again our elders, who we are trying to say now, move on out with dignity. That's why they are holding the country. And it's true to you. When I get my money, what do I think first? Me. I never think about Kenya. Me, itapataje hapa. Itatokoaje hapa. It is a culture we need to pray to God to come out of it. It is a culture we need to ask ourselves, will it build for the generations that are coming? Will they find a country as we found a country? Or they'll come and ask, who are there? Did they leave a mark that we are able to get some resources? Or we just want to eat all, because I can see we are there to grab and finish. And even sell the country while we are sitting, because we also sell our lands when our mothers are there. They wake up and they find somebody on the door. Hii shamba inuzwa kitambo, loan ilichukuliwa. So the same thing. So we should not blame anyone. We should not blame government. We should ask who is government. It is me, you, and them. Because you are the one who pay tax. You pay tax to that institution to work. It's very important as we look at the findings to ask ourselves as a church, what are we going to do with the issue of reconciliation? When you look at Moyale, this thing of fighting of tyranny of numbers, it's going to finish this country. And the tyranny of numbers is not just on the large communities. Tyranny of numbers is what is finishing in Moyale right now. It's what is finishing in Northeastern. This clanism and my tribe has to rule. My tribe has to do this. It's a very dangerous thing, and it's only the church in the 90s that assisted the whole process. So I want to throw back the ball to the church and say, let us not fight for the material things we are fighting. Because that has carried us away also. That we find ourselves fighting for property. Like, then you ask yourself as an individual church member, so where do I go if already my leaders are fighting for property? And in the church we used to believe I'll come back to those leaders to dialogue. We are not even dialogue system. Because even as we are grumbling for it, and we are also grumbling, and we are wondering. And we are pushing us away. I want to finish and say, I thank the Pope, and I thank God for giving us Pope Francis. Because he has come back to remind us as Catholics, and that's why he told the youth, go back to the diocese and change it. Do a mess. Bring it upside down. He was not meaning bring it just upside down. He meant go and bring back what we believed in as Catholics. That the social system, that believing in the poor, that working for everyone to have something. This thing of me alone should come out completely, and we must agree we have to change even in the church. Or else, that is why the youth will be looking for other churches where people talk differently as we speak. And they are moving. So it is time we embrace as we start, as we move on, as we look at the findings, and I believe, Director, you will share it with us so that we also share it with the leaders of this country and the governors. I want to say for me, as a Catholic, we were taught one something with one father called Father Jerry. It is better you tell them the truth, and God will judge you. So for me, I want to ask the clergy, let us go back to where the vows we agreed we will work for the people, and the revolution will work. As I conclude, I want to say the Senate is ready and willing, and it will go a long way to ensure the revolution works. We will look at the governors, and if they are not careful, before 5 years, we will impeach one or two, for sure, so that we bring in public. With those very few remarks, I want to declare this workshop open.